Hi Artur and hi everybody. Thank you for this presentation. My name is Youriy Kinov and I will talk about the data warehouses and data marts. Shortly, I have many years experience with data warehousing and also some years with cloud technologies. So today I will discuss what is a data warehouse, what is a data mart, what is the difference between them, what is the ownership of the data in different cases, and what is data governance. So data warehouse, it is a big database which contains data which is not part of the operational system of some application or other more complex system. Usually the operational system contains data for 1 or 2 years ago, which is necessary for the normal operating of the system. All the information which is older and in some cases operational data could be very big. So the data which is not necessary for direct operational needs, it is stored in a data warehouse. So the data warehouse, it is a big database, usually very big, which contains two types of data. One of them, it is historical data, which is stored there just to have it for many years. And another type, it is for different analysis, which could differ by the structure and by some other elements and organization, because this data could be reorganized according to the needs of some reporting, analysis, and different reasons. Data mart, it is a small part of the data warehouse, usually it is separated by some reason or purpose. It could be internal or external, and I will discuss this in the further slides. So, as I said, data warehouse, it is a big database which contains two types of data, one for just storage to have the history, and another for analysis. The data mart, it is a smaller part of this data, which could be for different departments of the company, or different divisions which are placed in different countries, and they have some specifics and need the data to be separated because of regulations, rules, and some other reasons. So these reasons will be discussed further in the presentation. Generally, there are two ways of building such a big structure. As every software, it could be done top-down or bottom-up. There are two people who explain different approaches how to build it. Normally, when a company starts its development, all the development is done top-down because the central company is growing, new divisions are created, and the centralized data could be divided according to the needs of these new divisions. The opposite approach, bottom-up, when is created, there are many divisions which are existing up to this moment. For example, let's say one bank comprises many offices, but these offices, for some reason, they already have their information systems and their information. Or maybe one company which is trading with something buys some other companies which already have their infrastructure and their data. In this case, the different divisions already exist and they have to be somehow integrated and centralized in one organization. I just explained about the use cases of these two cases when the data warehouse is created first and when the data marts second. Generally, the data warehouse is necessary for the central management and it is in use in big organizations which have big data. This data is necessary for the central management so that the central management could monitor all the processes which happen and perform different analysis depending on the business and on their needs. But all this is centralized. Data marts are applicable when different departments or subdivisions of the company need information which is specific to their direct work, direct business. And this could be, this separation could happen in many ways, internally, externally, and it will be discussed in the next slides.
Youriy, sorry for interruption, Bartek had a question.
Okay.
Yes, I have a question. Could you explain more what does it mean top-down and bottom-up architecture?
Top-down means that shortly it will be described in the next slides, but top-down means that there is one information which part and which has a data warehouse. The data warehouse contains all the data which is not directly.
Sorry, you're dropping. You're dropping. Your quality of the sound is actually quite poor.
How it is now?
Now it's fine, but yeah, it seems like something with your headphones.
Okay. The data warehouse, when we're talking from top-down and bottom-up, top-down means that the data warehouse, central data warehouse is developed. It contains all the data which company has. And after that, this information is somehow divided for different departments. It will be explained in the next slides. Bottom-up, it means that for some reason, already some parts of information system are existing. For example, if bank branches are existing and one central management is trying to to integrate all the information, then different branches and different data marts already exist. And it is necessary to build something which to collect information from them and manage it centrally. Additionally, it could be when one company, which is centralized, buys other businesses, other companies, which are in different countries, and they already have their information systems, their small data warehouses, which in this case could be treated as data marts, and they are integrated in one central data warehouse. Is it? Did I answer your question? Or
yes, I understand now. Thank you very much.
Okay. Welcome. So here I will explain one aspect of the differences, and later there will be other. I will look from other point viewpoints on this subject. So generally, in data warehouse is in use when we have enterprise-wide organization, and data marts when there are domain-specific departments or other subdivisions. So shortly, you can read all which is written in this table, and I will explain not reading each of them, but mainly the data warehouse is necessary and it is useful for the central management of a big organization, enterprise. And data marts could be different fragments and different parts of this big information according to the needs of these divisions, or this could be departments or any other kind of subdivisions. So shortly, the data warehouse, it is a big database, and each data mart, it is a smaller part of this. And each data mart, it is a smaller and simpler part because, for example, the central database contains information for financing, marketing, customer relationship, some manufacturers, if there is any. And data marts, they are separated. One of them for marketing, another for finance, and so on. Or maybe they could be separated by countries or other divisions. And I will go further through these subjects. The data warehouse needs longer time for development, and it usually happens slower. The data marts could be developed faster because they are simpler, and usually they contain relatively smaller data than the big data warehouse. And of course, the price in one case for the data warehouse, the price is higher, and for data marts, it is lower. How the data marts could be divided from the data warehouse, it depends on the structure of the business. But as I said, this could be by internal reasons like marketing, finance, manufacturing, and so on, or divided by countries because there are different regulations which require, for example, information related to European customers or, yes, customers. The information has to reside on servers in Europe. There is a similar regulation for USA, Canada, and other countries in the world. So this could be another division of the data marts.
Youriy, could I ask one question?
Yes.
Could I ask you to elaborate on how to choose between Inmon and Kimball? So just imagine we have a new project. So you said that Kimball is when the organization already has some data and maybe analytics. But usually, at least when I try to understand in the internet, usually people say that the Kimball approach is used to speed up the initial development when you just develop data marts and integrate them with like conform dimensions. And Inmon in turn is for bigger projects when you want to have bigger initial commitment, but then a quicker spin off of data marts. So they usually refer to the complexity, number of teams, number of business units, the scale of the project. But you discussed from the other perspective, like what company already have. Could you please elaborate how to choose? Maybe you have a kind of decision map between Kimball and Kimball, some approach.
No, you are right, but all this topic is so complex, and there are so many different viewpoints. So yes, what you explain, it is completely true. And in the next slides, I was preparing to say something similar. So yes, you are right. And these are just different aspects of the same topic. So yes, you are right that for some in some cases it is much easier and faster to develop data marts because it is faster, easier, and so on. So you are completely right. It is not. I don't see a problem here. Is it something that you like to discuss more detailed?
Okay. No. If you meant the same thing, okay. I just saw you say that it depends. It depends on what company already have. And I thought that I'm missing something. But is that the same just in different ports, then that's okay.
Yes, shortly, Inmon explains why and how to develop it top-down, and Kimbo explains how to develop it bottom-up. Of course, all this depends on many, many reasons and factors, which company will decide and do in this or in the other way. So what you say, it is completely true.
Okay, thank you.
So shortly, the data warehouse, it is, as I said, it is a big database which collects information from, let's say, many different sources. This could be different modules of one operational system, or maybe more than one system, and the data is collected in the data warehouse. So, as I understand, all the people in the auditorium already know about the subject. So, if I explain too much things that you know, I can go faster over this presentation. But shortly, the data warehouse collects information from different sources, and it could be just stored for historical reasons, or there could be performed business intelligence, which is more interesting and more applicable in the last years, because there are many benefits from this. The data marts, as I said, they are different parts of this big data warehouse structure, or they could be independent parts which later are integrated in one big data warehouse. So they are dependent, independent, and hybrid. And in the next slides, I will show some structure of them and information about them. The advantages of data marts, as we already discussed, it is the main advantages are that the data is smaller, simpler, and the data mart is much easier and faster for development. Snowflake, it is a different structure which tries to replace the necessity of dividing the big data warehouse in small data marts, because the Snowflake, the structure Snowflake allows the data to be centralized in one place, but divided in many different directions and aspects, depending on the needs of the company which is using this data warehouse. Shortly, the data marts in the cloud, so all the information systems and especially data warehouses in the current days are moving and migrating in the cloud. And of course, data warehouses and data marts also are part of this migration. So because of many regulations in different countries, what and how is necessary to be stored where, as I said, the information for all the European users have to be placed and to reside in servers which are in Europe territorially. There are additional restrictions for USA, Canada, Israel, Asian countries, and so on. So when any international company is operating worldwide, then such existence of data marts will be necessary, and the different data marts will be stored in the necessary regions and countries and availability zones according to the cloud terminology. So shortly, this is the structure of, as I said earlier, all the data in the data warehouse is placed in one place, and it is treated as one structure. And the data marts could be separated. This is this slide shows how the information could be separated in subdivisions of one company. These are departments: marketing, finance, sales, manufacturing, if any, and so on. So this is About the dependent data marts, firstly, the information is collected, stored in one central data warehouse, and then divided in these subdivisions. And when the data marts are independent, then the information could be collected and directly transferred in some data mart without any central processing in the central data warehouse. So generally, when having a central data warehouse, then we have one or more cubes with their dimensions. And after that, this marketing, sales, and finance information could be some division of these cubes or the dimension of these cubes. But in the other case, when they are independent, then the information is just collected, transferred to the necessary data mart, and there is no other central processing of this data which is collected. As I said earlier, this could be internal separation or international separation. About the marketing, finance, and others, I just explained. About international business types, there are when one international company is working in different countries, for many reasons, the information which is related to one country or your state in United States, for many reasons, the information has to be placed and to be available and accessible only in this country or state. And this is one reason why the data in the data warehouses could be separated in data marts, so that each data mart resides and is accessible only for people in this country or state. There are regulations like GDPR and many others for all the big countries in the world, which require the information, to be residing and accessible only in this region and only in this country. Additionally, when a company supports franchising, then this company could require that all the information is processed in a similar way. The structures and the structure of the information is supported one and the same in all the cooperating companies which are using this franchise, but each separate company could has own part of the information, which is a different kind of data mart, and then all the ownership and operating with this data is more responsibility of the franchise organization, the child organization which is using this franchise, but also the central management has to collect and access this data, and this is why the data has to have the same structure. This is another comparison of data warehouses and data marts. Generally, it is similar, but it is more from a business point of view. So when there is a data warehouse which collects information, and after that it is provided to the different data marts, then the centralized database becomes a single source of truth where data is collected. There could be some pre-processing, and after that to be separated in data marts. The data marts, in opposite, they provide easy access to their data, which is collected directly by them or in their region or their instance of the database. And after that, this data is integrated and centralized in the central data warehouse. So, data warehouse is in use when there is a business with where the business wants to have a wide vision about what happens in all the subdivisions. But the data mart is more useful in cases when there is a department specific information which has to be available only for them. The decisions which are made based on the data warehouse, they are strategic, and they are again more than the top management, more for the top management, and made by the top management. And the data mart is oriented for operational and tactical decisions, which are typical for the corresponding subdivision. And the score. Okay, I will not read one by one all these cells, but generally the central data warehouse collects all the data, and it is used by the central management to analyze what happens inside the company. Generally, it is more complex, and it needs more time, longer time for development. It costs more, and the information is much bigger than in each data mart. The data marts they contain information which is necessary for internal department or country-specific business and other subdivision. Generally, the ownership of data it is always by the top management. And additionally, some of this, the information could be cooperatively owned by these subdivisions. For example, there are requirements that according to the requirements, right, like GDPR and all the others in the world, when some country or union needs that the information is stored on its territory, and information which is, for example, for each European country, it has to be available and regulated and managed according to the rules of this country. So all the subdivisions of the big international company which is working worldwide, all the subdivisions residing in different countries, they have to own their information, and this information to be managed according to the rules of this country or union. Data governance, it is a process of managing all this data to be available, usable, to have good integrity and consistency. And the data management, it is the effective management of all this information, which ensures consistency, availability, integrity of the data, and its usage according to the rules, first of all, to the central management, and secondly, to all the subdivisions which could be regulated by national or international regulations in different regions of the world. It is a big subject, and it is a big topic, and it could be discussed in another presentation, but generally the governance, the purpose of the data governance is to ensure all these elements and components of management of the information. So shortly, this is what I had to explain about all this topic. And now you can ask your questions, because I saw there are such questions, and we can go back for different details in this topic.
I will start, if I may. Thank you for the presentation. And I have a question from the business perspective. and scalability perspective. So in many cases, we can see that companies, they want to, you know, start small, prove value, and scale out of there. Is there a best practices on how to, you know, start from data mart and then scale to data warehouse? Should you take into account, I don't know, some architecture questions in this perspective? What's the way to scale from, for example, marketing department to, I don't know, HR department or anything else? So do you have best practices around this? So you can set, we'll start small, we'll build data mart, we'll take into account that, you know, you may grow or scale from there, and then we'll have a next step. So what the best practice is here?
There are, it could, it very much depends from the business, because okay, the best practice, the main point in which has to be kept in mind in this case, it is to have a good organization of the data which is already available, and to have some standards. It is good to be structured, to have good as good as possible organization of the data, so that it is structured. In some cases, it is not possible to be structured, but because this is why there are relational databases and non-SQL databases, because in some cases the data cannot be aligned to the relational database rules. But the best practice in this case, it is to have standards, which later could allow different data marts to be integrated in one system, because we cannot require all the businesses to follow one and the same logic, philosophy, and standard, but they have to have the same standard on their different subdivisions and their data marts. So the best practice is to as early as possible to standardize the structure of their data. This is what I can say very universally, because otherwise we have to go in details for different businesses. Why in one case one organization is better, why in another case another organization is better, but it is recommendable that all the subdivisions have as much as possible similar or the same structure. Then it will be easier to build the central data warehouse. Is it enough?
Yeah, thank you. So just to clarify, then in this case, from the day one, you should also think not only about, you know, single data mart, but also a little bit broader context to see, you know, what the possible future, and try to, you know, to build this future integration already in your mind, at least on the architecture side.
Yes, it is recommendable to be. I know that it is not always possible, but the best case, it is if it is possible at the beginning to think about all this and to think. If not, this could be done later, but it will cost more time, money, and effort, and everything else.
Thanks.
We have one more question in our chat. Youriy, how you usually start working on data warehouse design? What is the starting point?
It is an interesting question, because in different cases it is different. Of course, the business of the organization which needs new data warehouse, if there is some not template, but structure which is typical for this kind of business, then it is better to apply as much as possible this template or standard or framework, how the things are done for this business or for the other business. First of all, because it is easier for any further development. And secondly, because this will make the new data warehouse more or less standard according to the rules in the same business. And it will be easier for this company to integrate further in any other with any other partners. So first of all, there are, let's say, they will not be template, but design patterns, which are typical for different businesses. This is one of the starting points. And of course, discussions with the people who are managing the business, what they need, what they have as information, what are the processes of their company, business processes, which have to be supported by this data warehouse, and what targets they have, what has to be achieved. And after this analysis, of course, again, if there are more or less known design patterns, it is better to apply them, not because we are lazy, but because it is much better to have standard decisions than very, very unique decisions and designs. So firstly, something typical for this business, and secondly, discussion with the management, what they need to achieve. Is it enough for this answer to explain more?
Yes, very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Sorry, could you clarify on this answer? What do you mean by design patterns? It's something not just Kimball versus Immon, right? Maybe you can suggest any resource we can find some of the patterns.
For example, if we are talking about bookkeeping information, normally the bookkeeping every month has to be closed. There are some reports, and all the months which are earlier than the current month, they have to be archived, and the data there cannot be modified after the month is closed. So this is one design pattern, and then the data has to be stored and maybe partitioned according to its size. It could be partitioned in for years, for each year one partition, or for each month depending on the size of the data, or for each day if the data is very big. And it is clear that when 1 month is closed, there are some reports which are prepared. This data is archived, and it has not to be modified any further. This is one kind of design pattern. If there are, let's say, big company with international business, and this company has to store the information for the departments which are residing in different countries, each department has to, or subdivision, this could be a child company or trading division of the company, their information has to be stored in a separate place and not accessible for the others. Then the data has to be divided according to these subdivisions. And this could be either different dimensions in a big cube, if there is a cube, or this could be different data marts separated by department, by country, or by any other division which is necessary. And it is also a kind of design pattern. It is not a good idea to put all the data in one place and after that to think how to divide the access to this data on row level in the tables. So we can have different partitions, and then, for example, partitions or different instances of the databases where the access to this data could be regulated much easier. So these are two types of design patterns. If it is enough, I can stop here. If you like, I can continue with more examples how the data could be organized.
Yeah, that's enough.
So I'm talking about such design patterns, not having ready structures of tables and apply them everywhere. It is a more top level design pattern.
Okay, thank you.
If no questions, I may ask one more question. Just returning, sorry, to Kimball versus Ilman. I'm not a data warehouse guy, but I work a little bit with Kimball, and I'm a little interested in when someone can choose Ilman approach over Kimball. And usually, as we discussed, people referring to the scale of the project, but you said about the readiness of the data, right? So for example, is there any use case when you would say that for small or mid-sized project, like when you have just team up to 10, I don't know, engineers, you will choose Ilman over Kinov, like, and be very sure about that. Just to understand a person who didn't work with Ilman and just only read.
Yes. In the current days, it is very modern to have startups which are developing something interesting. And let's say you can have a startup which starts in one country, producing something or trading something, and they have their business in one country. They are growing, and after that, after some time, they decide to extend their business out of this country, let's say in second, third, and so on. So in this case, there will be top-down development because the company starts in one country. There are regulations and all the rest which are specific for this country. They are building their operating system and data warehouse, which is supporting their business. And when they extend the business out of this country, then all the other separations start to appear. So they can have one data mart for their first country and another data mart for the second, third, and so on countries where their business is growing. So this is one example for top-down development. If you have a company which is already big and this company is buying, let's say a coffee shop, they have business in one or more countries, and they decide not to develop new department in a new country, but to buy some existing company which is already working on this market, and they just buy them and make them part of the bigger company. Then the company which is already existing and it is bought, this company has its information system, maybe data warehousing, and then this new part, new data mart, has to be integrated in the central database. So this is example for the opposite, from bottom up.
Okay.
Is it enough clear?
I have some doubts about the first example where you have different countries. So why can't you do that with? Why do you think Ilman is better than Kimball in this example? If you can elaborate.
Sorry, could you please? Because I don't hear you. Time to time, it is interrupted.
In first example when you have startup and many data marts in different countries, why would you go in one way instead of Kimball?
You can do both of them, but Kimball, it is, as I said, it is typically Kimball is developed when you have units which are existing independently, and after that you have to integrate them. In Mon, it is applicable when we have one structure which is growing. So, of course, if you have a startup which is operating in one country and after that starting in another, of course you can build a new data mart and after that integrate it. But it is strongly recommendable to have the same structure, this data mart, to have the same structure as much as possible, the same structure as all the other existing. So this structure could vary because of some local regulations or other reasons, but it is better to have the same structure so that it is easier to integrate it in the future in the global warehouse. Otherwise, you have, let's say, more problems, necessity of more effort to integrate it later. So in this case, you can think that the new data mart is created independently and after that integrated. But it is strongly recommended to have the same structure. So in this context, it is a new part of the central system. So because of this, I think that it is top down. But if you prefer to think that the new data mart is independent and after that integrated, it is also okay.
Okay, thank you very much. I think I got it.
Okay, well, welcome.
One more question from my side. It's a real case. For example, you have the data mart for marketing, and then you have data mart for HR or any kind of business, or even different verticals. You know, the data mart for, you know, financial department, and data mart for, you know, healthcare. And then you need to take a part of data from both, and, you know, analyze kind of the data from two different data marts. Should you create the third one? Or you can just, you know, take the needed data from both of them and process it somehow?
Both of them are possible. If it is something accidental, or it is or if it is easy, you can take information from both of existing data marts and somehow use it and present a report or something else which is necessary. But if this is related to collecting every time a lot of data, it is much better to think how to make another data mart and to organize processing so that this data mart is applied with the necessary information. So here, the main important point is how easy or difficult is to create your new reports. If it is something easy, you can use the existing data marts. If it is something which takes a lot of time and effort every time, every day, every month, or every other period of time, then it is much better to have a new data mart so that you minimize the processing of this information, because usually this costs money. Generally, it is also discussable which is better, to have information which is existing, let's say more than one copy of some information, or to process it every time. Generally, in the cloud, providers, the storage is cheaper than the processing time, CPU time. So usually it is better to have another copy of the data you need than to calculate it every time you need it. So it is a matter of thinking, discussing, and deciding which is better. But if we are talking about small and easy collectible data for your reports, it is better to take them from existing data marts. If it is something bigger, it is better to create a new data mart.
Yeah, thank you very much.
On all these topics could be explained much more, but I saw that just from the beginning of this presentation, some people are asking questions, which question shows that the auditorium already knows about the topic. This is why I explained what I explained. If necessary, I can explain much longer and wider, but if you have questions, we can continue with your questions.
Youriy, it seems like there are no more questions.
No. Yes. Yeah.
So I just want to say thank you. Thank you so much for presenting this information for our community. Thank you so much for this talk. And I hope that you will perform for our community again in future and present this topic wider.
Okay. Thank you, Arthur. Thank you too. And okay, it could happen.
Yeah, and dear participants, please don't forget to leave your feedback. Your feedback is really important for us, and we analyze your comments and do some improvements and changes. Thank you for attending our events. Have a good day, and we'll be waiting for you at our next events. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you, Youriy. Bye.
Yeah. Bye.
Thank
bye.
You. Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.